Four border breachers trying to cruise to Cairns on board their new boat thought they weren't doing anything wrong. The costly maiden voyage cut short, their catamaran now abandoned on the Gold Coast. And the Premier says land, air, rail or sea, lawbreakers will be busted.
This is the Maggie May, Queensland's COVID catamaran. Intercepted off the Gold Coast yesterday, Maritime Safety cutting short her high seas border breach, shipping its crew into police custody and delivering them straight to hotel quarantine. Today, friends sent to collect their belongings from the boat in a kayak.
All I can tell you is that boat will be there for 2 weeks.
The four people who were on board are from Cairns, returning home from a New South Wales hotspot without a border pass. Nine News understands the 16-metre, $375,000 houseboat had just been purchased from Newcastle.
They have all been fined for making a false declaration, and they are now enjoying hotel quarantine at their own expense.
A very expensive lesson at that. A grand total of $23,500. A reminder, the Premier says, that while police and the army man the roads, our maritime borders are being monitored around the clock too. You will need proof of ID and a valid pass, and if you're coming from a hotspot, you can only come by air.
They are watching all of our borders. It's not just the airports, the train stations, the road, they're also monitoring the waters as well.
This is all the proof you need of just how seriously the government is taking our border lockdown. Understandably, those four people are quite upset. Their friends tell me they were blindsided yesterday. Surprised to learn the rules are being enforced even at sea. They were under the impression that because the journey to the states far north would take them 2 weeks, that they'd be able to quarantine on the boat. Unfortunately, that is not the case. And now the trip home has cost them a whole lot more than they were bargaining for, Jonathan.
It has indeed. Mackenzie, thank you. Taken ashore under the cover of darkness, two men who tested positive for COVID-19 on a cargo ship from China are tonight in hospital as Queensland reaches a coronavirus milestone.
Dressed in hazmat suits, the two men infected with COVID-19 are able to walk themselves to waiting stretchers, brought to shore by a police boat from the Globe Electra bulk carrier, which was heading for Townsville from China when the two crew members fell ill. Police and ambulance officers helping the men dressed head to toe in protective gear, a reminder of the risk they're taking to help COVID patients.
We have very strong measures in place, so I want to reassure the community.
As the ambulance leaves, a deep clean begins on the police boat to try and stop the virus from spreading.
We are monitoring the rest of the crew.
Right now, there are 9 active cases of COVID-19 in Queensland.
There were no new cases of COVID-19 overnight, and in more good news, Queensland has gone 14 days with no community transmission of the virus.
The Premier warning Queenslanders to keep up the prevention measures this ecca-long weekend. Today, Anastasia Palaszczuk attending a socially distanced ceremony marking the 75th anniversary of victory in the Pacific Day.
To think that during these times we can have a COVID-safe event. There were 8 veterans from World War II who joined us.
Ebony Cavallaro, 9 News.